Bubba went to play pickleball with Helms yesterday. Somewhere between 11 and 15 minutes in, Bubba went down with a groin pull, tear, whatever it is, to the point that Helmsy had to help him get in his automobile and pumped gas for him. He was then sent home to the care of his loving wife, Betty Lou Bussey, who is here today because you had to give Bubba a ride to work.
Sure.
So Betty was not at home at this point in time, so you had to manage that on your own.
Right.
And so in the meantime,
I had
Betty
to fight through the raccoons and get on
Betty
in the
reaches
house.
Out to me to kind of see, hey, what's going on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So we have a phone message from Betty. Now she's being brought into the loop, and Helmsy has it here. So we're going to play a phone message. We have asked for Betty's permission to play
right.
it. Graciously giving it to us.
So your day turned too, didn't it, Betty?
Yeah. Oh, sure. Yeah. I didn't say anything bad in there, I hope. I don't think there's any bad words.
There you go.
We'll beep it out.
Hey, Ham. Betty. So it's come to this. We've pulled our crotch muscles playing the blue hairs at a church gym today. Is that right here? I'm headed home to try to nurse the sick. But, yeah. I don't know about a groin muscle. I think it's going to take a while. As Greg says, I don't know if we got the tools to pull this off. But anyway, good grief. Okay, here we go. Well, all right. That's all I have. I'll talk to you later.
Did Betty say he pulled a crotch muscle?
He did.
Blue hair.
Sounded like Betty was giving herself a pep talk.
She was talking it out. I was trying to just muddle my way through it. Because I'm trying to shop yesterday, and at 11:34, I get a text from Bill.
I know. Your day took a turn.
And it says, 11:34. Y'all just got off there at 10 o'clock or whatever. I thought, well, surely.
I know.
Where are you? Pulled groin playing pickleball.
That was your text.
Can hardly walk. Yeah. And I said, what? You know, so, and then that was it. Silence.
You know how we have famous quotes that will last forever in Rick and Bubba lore? I can see it now. So let me get this straight. He tore a crotch muscle playing the blue hairs over at the church in pickleball. ... Betty Lou Bussey.
Well, all right.
Well, I get home. And I go back there, and he's in the bed. And have you eaten lunch? I said, lunch? I said, you didn't even eat lunch before you pulled a groin muscle or whatever? So anyway, I told him I was not going to be an enabler. I had watched that 600-pound life.
Yeah.
And people keep bringing them food. They can't get out of the bed. I said, oh, no. I said, your worst nightmare has come to fruition today. Today is the day.
Anyway. You get to decide what he eats. You can bring him a salad.
I did. I brought him a big old thing of grapes. And a few chicken nuggets. Not many.
Like, more grapes than nuggets.
Bubba, you're trapped now. She decides what you eat.
Yeah, it was.
Boy, he suddenly got better.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that was a motivator.
I bet it did.
Now, remember, Betty is an RN, so, yes. You know, sometimes her bedside manner is not as caring as I'd like for it to be.
Well, you know how you always try to look for the silver lining? She found it.
No,
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I wanted a little bit of sympathy. You know, I was in agonizing pain, but, boy, she comes in with both barrels.
Oh, yeah.
She is on me.
She get on you?
I said, when we do get over this, I mean, buddy, we are going to the gym, and I mean, I don't want to hear it. Anyway, I mean, we are going to stretch, and we're going to work it out.
So it's a new day, right, Benny?
It really is. And last night, we get in the bed. I had to visit. It was about like you getting him in the Jeep, trying to get him in the bed.
Mm-hmm.
So then I pull up what a groin pull is supposed to be or whatever. I actually looked it up. And it says, groin pulls are common in people who play sports and require a lot of running and jumping. I'm like, what have you played a sport that requires running and jumping? Why do you have a groin pull?
How did this happen?
So pickleball wasn't on the list?
No. And then I'm like, he can't get his position to sleep. So therefore, I can't either. You know?
Right,
and
sure.
So I said, how should I sleep with a pulled groin muscle? You can look that up. Change your sleeping position. Keep experimenting to find the most pain-reducing position.
That's what he was doing.
Place wedge-shaped pillows under your hip to provide cushioning. Sleep with a pillow between your knees. I just started laughing. I thought, this means we're not going to get any sleep. Neither one of us. Yeah, I'm work because I'll be up. Yeah.
Wide awake.
I am getting something out of this.
No problem taking you to work. I'll be up.
Yeah.
Look at you.
Yeah, that whole little lingo they were giving you is they're basically telling you ain't gonna sleep. You ain't gonna sleep anyway. Good luck.
Not a bit.
Betty, you were discussing a moment ago that Bubba seemed to overcome his pain tolerance. It seemed to go up just a few moments ago.
It's amazing when the Chick-fil-A came in. You know, he hopped on up, went on over there to the kitchen. It really is amazing.
She looked at me and said, well, I'll tell you what, now his tolerance for pain is suddenly much higher. Yeah. Betty.
Good night alive. I mean,
what's your day like today?
Gosh, I don't know. I think we're headed to the therapist. I don't know where we're going.
Everybody needs a motivation to work through rehab.
Right.
And I think Betty's found it.
I think so.
As long as she's in charge of what you get to eat, I mean, that'll motivate you to get up on your feet.
Well, yesterday it really wasn't a problem because the pain was so that food was not an issue.
Right. And she looks like she has
and
a rest.
Mysteriously, my back or my knee wasn't hurting.
No.
I couldn't feel it.
All that concentration got moved somewhere else.
Your brain's busy on something
else. It's a new day when he recovers.
It is. His stomach was growling so loud this morning it woke me up.
Well, it's not used to that.
We had a piece of salmon and some grilled vegetables.
Dang, Bubba, really?
That was great.
Yeah. Yeah. Couldn't get up, huh, Bubba?
Wasn't a lot of it. It really was good.
A lot of plate.
Yeah, a lot of plate. No, Betty's a great cook, and you know she will take good care of me, I'm sure. And I will have to tell you this through all of this, and I mean this. I don't want to get too serious here, but you know, Betty is a wonderful, wonderful lady. And I'm very honored to have her as my wife, as we just celebrated 30 years, last week.
Mm-hmm.
And she's a godly woman. She walks with God every day. She is a Proverbs 31 lady. And, you know, there's so many things I can say. She's beautiful. She's sexy.
Oh.
We have a great time together.
But she's going to let you eat.
But the thing is.
You just ruined the conversation.
You did it again.
Good night.
Look at that. Rick and Bubba.